Happy Saturday evening, everyone. Tonight, in Season 2, Episode 5 of What Is My Story Today, we will talk about what does going on adventures foster. So with that, I have invited a good friend of mine in SGV & Company, Joven Sabana, to talk about the topic. But before that, let me thank our dear sponsor for tonight's episode, Mr. Rightstyle Fragrances. So without further ado, let me invite our dear guest of honor for tonight's episode, Joven Sabana.
There.
Oh, hi. Oh, God, it's so funny.
Yay. Hi. Thank you. How are you?
Yeah, I'm good. I'm not used to this. But, yeah, let's go.
Yay. First of all, I would like to thank you for accepting my invitation. I know you're so busy right now because
no bother.
It's again. And I appreciate your time to have this discussion. So hopefully we can share a thing or two. Yes, very formal. Hopefully, I'm looking forward.
So formal. Ito formal mo, Bon.
Wait lang, may nagsabi dito, si CFS Back League. Go, mama.
Ano kaya yung mga friends?
Anyway,
nagkakot ako ng audience kasi baka langawin this. You know. Kahit walang kwenta yung pagsasabi ko, sige na, Von. Tuloy.
Sige, wait lang. Oh, meron pa isa, si JKR Sepe, kabog. Jowa
mo. Oo, friend ko, yan, hayaan mo na yan. Tuloy na.
Wait lang. Anyway, first of all, thank you again. And my very first question for every guest that I invite here is, how are you today?
Masaya. I am happy. I'm happy and fresh.
Yeah.
I think. Mm-hmm.
Okay. Meron pa isa, si This is Pepita. Ang dami mo namang ano?
Mga ano ko yan? Mga fans ko nga. Hi, mga fans.
Oh, sige. Anyway, so later.
Alam mo magiging comedy bar to? Hi, mga fans. Kasi maraming mga...
Wait lang.
Huwag kayong manood ng live na to kasi walang kwenta yung sasabihin ko. Pero, sige, bahala kayo.
Oh, sige. Later, no, let us allow our audience to also ask questions about adventure, no, so that ano, they can also consider their thoughts for this conversation.
Tara, I very miss you yung format nito. Mayroon po may question and answer from the audience. Okay, proceed.
Okay, first question. Let's talking about adventures. Let's not go far, no.
God, I'm so nervous.
So talking about your hometown, Palawan. No? So how would you describe Palawan to every one of us, Joven?
My God, I really need to describe Palawan. Yeah. Palawan is a paradise.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, because it has like beautiful beaches and yeah, it has also mountains and yeah, everything. It has everything.
Mm-hmm.
Including natural resources. Yeah.
True. Yeah, I wouldn't really know.
So, katawa naman to, Bon. Sorry. Sorry, sinisira ko ata yung ano mo nito, mag-guesting-guesting. Ano ata pinakalaro dito?
Hindi, ganun talaga. Okay lang yan. So, you said that okay. Palawan is paradise. So, for you, having lived in Palawan most of your life, Job, no? So, what moment do you cherish the most back in Palawan, in your at home?
Yeah, I think my childhood. I will cherish the most because I spent most of my formative years there.
Uh-huh.
So I was molded to be a sex bomb. Hi, Errol. This is sex bomb Joven. Laro talaga to, yeah. Because I think during young days, because parang I feel that everything is like I have access to everything. I mean not everything na parang what do you call this? I mean, every resources is mm-hmm. parang within sa amin lang. Like, yung mga basic needs.
Yeah,
like,
yeah.
We have, like, mga pananim sa loob ng bakuran, ganon. Mm-hmm. And then, also, the beach is 5 minutes away. So,
yeah.
I think that's it.
Sinabi mo nga yan, alala ko, you mentioned it to us last time, no? Nung nandito ka pa sa Philippines. Anyway, so, yes. You mentioned earlier also, Job, no, that Palawan is more of, let's say, it has a lot of beaches, mountain area also, and syempre, a lot of resources. So for you as a traveler, Joe, what type of a traveler are you? Let's say, do you enjoy city? Do you enjoy mountain area? Do you enjoy beach?
Or ano what? Lang ako. Yeah, I like, because I don't swim. So I don't swim, so I usually like enjoy mountains, ganon.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, okay, mga mountains, mga walk, nature, more on nature, yeah.
Okay. Sige. Wait lang, magbasa muna tayo ng comment dito.
Pag naglalaro talaga tong mga comments na to. Nag-appear pala to sa mga friend.
Andrea, ano ba Hime? Sorry if I don't read your handle right.
Oo.
Ganda naman. Sino pa? Si Errol kanina, no? Wait lang, ha?
Oo, sex bang daw ako.
Meron pa dito nagsabi, wait lang. Sorry, hindi ako sanay sa mga comment section dito. Wait a minute. Si...
Oo, hindi din ako sanay. Hindi kasi ako sanay sa live.
Chara. Batang tubig alat, kasali ka po ba sa Muruami? Sino to? Si Errol Villa.
Si Errol yan. Oo, sabi ko na sa'yo, lalaroin tong ano mo, live mo eh.
Diwata sa mountains, Andrea. Anyway, sige. It's fun din, oh. TikTok naman, friend. Si San Kisu.
Next time.
Oh, sige. Ayun. So, ayun. You mentioned...
Wait, laro talaga ito. Wait, natatawa ako. Sorry.
You mentioned laro to. Mountain, no? Mountain type of adventurer. And you also like mga walkings, no? I remember before when you mentioned to us na you can actually go to a place you have never been to on your own. So how did you build your confidence in doing that job? Why can you go to places even though you don't know where you're headed?
Yeah, I think I'm always confident, Juan. Even if I'm not really that. I think that's my one of my strengths is that I always feel confident. I mean, not really confident about myself, but confident in like going into places.
Uh-oh.
Like. Yeah, and of course, before going to places, you need to research about a particular place. Because, you need to consider that as well. But yeah, I think if you're gonna ask me where am I getting that confidence, siguro my parents kasi told me to... My parents kasi told me, my God, it's so... Anyway, kasi siguro my parents like practice parang maaga akong pinakawalan ng mga parents ko, like at the age of 12 I'm being independent na from them. So yeah, they provide for me, but at the age of 12 I live far away from them. That's why siguro medyo may confident din akong lumayas kung saan-saan. Ayun.
Yeah. Nice. At least, no?
O, diba? I'm so konyo. Hi, Ava. Shout out. O, diba? Di mo kaya. Ang dami kong fans.
So,
thanks, guys, for watching.
So, I think that's also part of your formative years, no? Kasi sabi mo nga, most of your, what you have learned in life also, no? Could be credited to how you lived your life in Palawan. So, ayun.
Yes.
So keep on lang commenting, no, for our audience. So feel free to ask questions also later on.
Oh, feel free to ask questions, guys.
So Job, eto na. So even you said now that you're confident enough to go to places, no? Even though you have never been there, no, at all. Now, which do you enjoy more? Solo travel or in a group travel? Because I've traveled with you na din with Jessa and Mama San before. So for you,
yeah, with Jess and Mama Sang, true. Shout out Mama Sang if you're watching. Hindi, siguro I enjoy. It depends. If I am with like a small group of people, like maybe 3 to 4, yeah, I enjoy traveling with a group. But if it's like parang
sobrang dami,
masyadong marami, parang masyadong marami, like a group of 10, parang I prefer na parang solo. Or depende din siguro sa mood, kasi parang if you're traveling solo, parang na feel mo din na parang yung parang na feel mo na parang independent ka and strong ka and parang may freedom ka, kasi parang if you're traveling with a group, parang you need to consider others as well. Yeah, you need to consider others in terms of like eating and then kung ano oras kayo aalis. And like when you're traveling solo, you can go wherever you want and yeah, you can go whenever you want. Ayun. Daming ambag, daming alam sa buhay.
Correct naman, no? So actually nakaka-stress yung group travel na malaki, kasi may mga iba dyan na hindi gustong gawin or puntahan yung gusto mo minsan na puntahan, which is also a sort of realization din na you need to be more patient, you need to understand others' preference. Although minsan nakakapikong din talaga.
Yes, Ben.
Kasi lalo na kapag may gusto ka talaga puntahan tapos ayaw na nila kasi pagod na or
yes. Not, no? At saka pag napapagod na yung iba.
So yun. So for you, so ano yung mga benefits that you can actually get from traveling? Either solo or in a group?
Ano, mental health. Oh, yeah. I mean, in this trying time, I think mental health. Yeah, parang it helps especially when I became like an OFW.
Mm-hmm.
I think traveling was like my comfort. It comforts me. I mean, it costly, yes, but
yeah.
If it's like good for your mental health, yeah, because sometimes when you are like traveling or even if it's solo or not, parang na happy ka when you go to different places. Na parang you think when you were younger, or it's some sort of also realizing your dreams. Because when you're younger, it's like, oh, this is just like on the books or on the books that I've read before. Ganon. Tapos
now you're there.
Napuntahan mo na siya. Parang nakaka-happy din siya. Parang na-happy din siya, parang nakakapag-provide rin siya ng happy hormones on your part. So yeah, I think most of, yeah, yung benefits na nabibigay ng traveling for me, even as a solo traveler or traveling as with a group, is, ayun, happiness. Happiness.
Yeah, yeah. Oh.
And sabi mental health.
Yeah. Correct. Sabi ni San Kisu, very well said, traveling makes you grow as a person.
Dami na mga ambag na mga friends ko. Hi mga friends, shout out.
So ito best. So, di ba, when we travel kasi, there are stages, no, before you even arrive to the destination, no? So there's preparation, there's the journey itself, there's the destination, no? At last, now that you've been there. So for you, which of these do you appreciate the most? The preparation, the journey itself, or the destination?
Ako ano? I think the journey itself.
Okay.
Yeah, the journey itself. Kasi parang, hindi kasi ako, I don't plan. I mean, okay, I don't really plan my trips. I just ensure that I have a flight ticket or I have the required documents and then the accommodation, yeah. And then money, of course. Parang yun lang, parang ganun lang siya. I'm not like the person who prepares. Some people like they prepare Excel file. Yeah, because may Excel file yung iba and then may mga places to travel. Ako spontaneous lang. So I think I like the journey itself.
Okay, nice.
When yeah, the journey. I think the journey and the destination.
Okay.
Yeah, dalawa pala. Charot.
Ayun, so even
alam mo, laro-laro lang to, no? Kala nyo, laro-laro lang to, no?
Wait lang. So even though you're a spontaneous traveler, so syempre, di ba, we need to trust the map, no? If ever. Kasi hindi naman pwede na, let's say, for example, it's really new to you.
Pero best naman dami na yung audience natin, best.
Pero for you,
bro, matatakot na.
Would you still stick to a map, or would you? I mean, when even though you have a map, no, with you, for example, or even let's say you know, naman na, let's say from your hotel to a certain point, no, of destination, you know where to go. So, are you more fond of just doing the usual route, or do you like taking alternative routes minsan? So, which do you prefer?
Kung saan mas convenient, charot. Hindi, kasi parang it depends kung saan mas convenient on your part. Kung hindi ka naman masyadong parang nagmamadali, or like me, sabi ko nga I'm a spontaneous like traveler. Hindi naman ako talagang self-proclaimed traveler, pero I travel. But when I travel, I think it depends on also kung goal mo talaga siyang puntahan. Pero kung hindi naman, parang okay lang naman kahit na yung usual route. But if you are aiming to, because some travelers, I think, there are some na parang they're aiming to like, go to this, go to that. Like, they have lists, but me, I don't have. So, yeah, I think I'll go for both. It depends on on the situation. It's a situation.
Yeah, correct. So ito, let's just backtrack a bit, no? So syempre, di ba, when you go on a trip, syempre you need to prepare your things, no? Let's say a few clothes or whatnot, no? So for you, if you go on a travel, what baggages do you leave and not bring with you?
Emotional baggages, syempre. O, diba? Di mo carry ang sagot, emotional baggages. Kasi, kasi you travel to be happy. Yeah, emotional baggages and of course, yung mga, siguro work-related na baggages. Kasi parang you travel to free up your mind and to be happy. And you need to just, I think you need to just bring yourself and few clothes and leave and your passport and leave everything. Leave everything sa bahay, like mga emotional baggages mo, kasi parang baka mamaya iiyak-iyak ka, 'di ba? Parang ay hindi pwede 'yun. Hindi daw 'yun pwede, sabi ni Mayor. So dapat we travel to make ourselves happy.
True.
Yeah. I think emotional baggages. What? Hindi mo kaya emotional baggages when traveling.
Okay. So now you mentioned naman kanina, 'di ba, that by traveling, it makes you happy, no? So, with all the places that you've been to, no, today, so what is the most important thing that you have brought back to you upon going home? Aside from happiness, yung mga or
what diba, kailangan mo interpret kasi di ko nagigets.
So, what do you bring back home after traveling? Anything. I don't want, I don't mean just the material things or what. Ano pa yung mga...
Parang wala. Charot. Walang pala natutunan. Wait lang. Isipin ko. I think, mahilig kasi ako magtsaa. So...
Okay.
Tapos sa... bawat places before the pandemic started, I usually collect tumbler. So I put my bag of tea there. So I think tumbler, kasi parang when I drink tea, parang it comforts me. So it's the same as I think I can relate that to traveling as well, that when I don't drink coffee, because I only drink tea, so it brings me comfort. Yeah, when I sip a tumbler of tea, not a cup of tea, so it brings me comfort. I think Tumblr Vaughn.
Okay, sige. Okay, that brings me to my next question, Joe. So when you sip that tumbler of tea, napakarami naman ng tumbler of tea. So,
grabe naman yung mga tanong dito. Parang kinabog ng Miss Universe. Anyway, sige.
So ano yung mas nare-remember mo, Joe? Is it the place? Is it the flavor of that tea? Is it the person that
it's
you're
the with? Feeling.
Or is
it's
that, the is
feeling.
It the memory? Yeah, okay.
Yeah, I think it's the feeling, not the place, Vaughn, but it's the feeling. Yeah. Parang it makes me calm, so parang kumakalma ako. So parang yeah, the same as traveling. Yeah, napapakalma niya din ako. I think that's it.
Okay. So if you Job, let's segue ko kasi mamaya yung next question. So if we talk about the farthest place that you've been to, so where is it right now?
Farthest? Yeah, kasi farthest. I think dito lang din. I think ito na yung farthest. This is the farthest.
Europe.
Yeah, I mean, magkakalapit lang naman yung mga countries dito. So, yeah, I think dito lang sa continent, sa Europe lang.
Okay. But this is the segue question. So in your mind, kasi syempre, di ba, people tend to imagine no places. So where is the farthest place in your mind that you've been to so far?
I think when you look at the map, it's Spain. Yeah, it's Spain because it's on the other side. I know, it's Malta. Yeah, where I came from before I moved to Ireland. I think it's Malta.
Hindi, nasa baba ba siya? Hindi ko alam eh.
Yeah, it's on the it's near the north ba? North Africa ata.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, malapit kasi siya sa Libya. So
ay kasi wait lang, kasi di ba doon ka galing? Sorry.
Oo, doon ako galing. Ano pa ulit tayo, bes?
Wait lang, kasi nakalimutan ko na lumipat ka na nga pala.
doon ako galing.
Late ko na na-realize. Sabi ko, parang doon siya galing.
Oo. I think that's the farthest.
Uh-huh. Okay. Now, siguro perhaps, let's talk about the pandemic naman. So, I know that you've shared a lot of good vibes sa SOCMED, no?
Grabe naman yung pandemic.
Wait lang! For your TikTok dances, kasi ako, nadaanan ko din kapag pinapost mo. So, aside from that, so what else have you done to compensate traveling when things are still not allowed before? When things are stricter?
So, yung feeling ko wala. Pero, napansin ko kasi during pandemic, I go to grocery a lot. Kaya tinan mo, laki-laki ko na. Yeah, I think I just travel to grocery. Yeah, to grocery yeah. shops. Kahit na I don't need something, I go there to buy anything na parang magpapahabi. Ganun lang.
Pero I would agree.
Kasi hindi pwede mag-travel eh.
Oh, agree. Grocery talaga yung naging happiness ng mga tao during the pandemic. Kasi parang hindi forward mo what to eat on a certain day, yung mas magpapahabi sa'yo na food. What to prepare para at least hindi ka na labas ng labas minsan kung gusto mo na may stock ka na talaga, no? Pero yun, like what you said nga, sometimes inevitable pa din na lumabas kasi nga gusto mo nga at least magliwaliw, no? Sa labas. Ayun, so now, this brings me to my next question. So, if there is one place that you wish you would go back again, so where would that be?
Ay, back again? Switzerland. Ang ganda niya kasi. Switzerland kasi parang when I went there, I literally cried.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know. Kasi parang, I think maybe because before, parang nakikita ko lang yung pictures. Pero nung parang yun yung place na parang napuntahan ko, ay, totoo ba? Parang totoo ba to? And that was also the first, yun yung first year na when I became an OFW. Actually, it's like parang 4 months pa lang akong OFW. O diba, di pa permanent sa work. Pero nag-travel na. Ayun. So, I think yun. Though expensive siya, pero I think yun yung babalikan ko. Pero kailangan din ng resources. So,
yeah. Ayun. Agree. So, ito naman, Joe, no? So, di ba sabi nga nila, in every travel, there's no really perfect scenario. There are really mishaps sometimes along the way. So for you, even though there are mishaps in your past travels, or I don't know, I'm not concluding. If there are, man, no. So would you think if you go back to that place again, would you try to create better memories, or would you just go with the flow like how you used?
Pa naman akong hindi ko matandaan kung may mga mishaps ba ako or wala. Pero if parang wala.
Nakalimutan.
Parang wala kasi. Charot. Hindi, parang meron naman. Meron naman natang mishaps yung naiwan yung baggage.
Yung luggage. Yung nangyari sa dumalig.
Ay, ano ba yun? Nakalimutan ko na yun. Ay, yung Ay, oo. Yung kumain ako ng panis na hotdog. Charot. Oh my God, nalaman na ng mga followers ko. Kaya, follow nyo na ako. Noong year 2017, that was May 2017.
Ako yung pinakamalalata. Ay, sige, sa ata. Ang dalawa.
Oo, ako yung, yun nga po, nakakain po kami ng panis na hotdog dahil hindi po namin na freezer. So, I think, yeah. Oo. Nabanggit naman na ni Von. Sige, yun na lang yung mishaps ko sa traveling. And lahat sila, sumakit yung shan. Ako lang yung hindi. Gaano katibay ang shan mo from Juan to Joven? Shout out, Nino Tria. Hello, girl! Charot.
Yan, Nino, hello! Nino, if may question
I think yun.
About adventures, paki-comment na lang.
Tingin ko gusto ko pa rin yun, Von. Ganun pa din. Kasi kaya lang naman yung sumakit yung shan, di naman ako eh. So, okay lang maulit. Bahala kayong magpa-albularyo. Di ba, na-albularyo pa yung isa? Nalagyan pa ng langis yung chat.
Naalala ko tuloy, sabi ko nga pa.
Di ba sabi ko sa'yo, feeling ko ito na yung magiging ano ko. Magsa-start na rin ako ng mga ganito mga live. Lalo mga comedy lang, mga tawa-tawa lang. Nilalaro ko na lang ito, Bon.
Asakit mo lang pang ako, wait.
Ay, Bon, huwag kang tatawa-tawa dyan. Ituloy natin ito, Bon. Kailangan ma-extra mo ito ng maayos.
Wait lang, sige, ito. Next question. So di ba sabi mo, you're fond of doing solo travel and just a small group. So if given the chance to, create your own itinerary, no, and invite people to go with you. So where would that be?
Ay, saan? I think, hindi ko pa napupuntahan yung Morocco eh. And maganda kasi yung Morocco. So. And walang visa. So I think Morocco.
So what is it in Morocco that captured you or you want to bring people with you? Or
Sahara Desert. Charot! Yung Sahara Desert. Yeah. Kasi diba, nasa books din yun. Lahat ng nasa books, goal palang puntahan. Yeah. Kasi it's in... Oo. At saka parang maiba, deserto. Yeah.
Nice. Actually, no, medyo maganda nga yung mga structures dun. Si Eva na pala parang taga doon. Parang naano ko sa ano niya sa mga vlogs. Anyway, sorry. Na-segue ko lang. Okay, anyway, so...
Ang dami mo namang alam. Siguro bes, in history ka siguro, bes. Inabandaran mo ko eh. Hindi ako natutuwa. Ako ang guest dito, dapat ako ang bida.
Charot lang. So ito. Now, if you arrive at your destination already, so ano yung pinakaunang ginagawa mo talaga? Is it, do you eat food? Do you go to this place? Do you experience this activity?
Bes, ito seryoso ha. Bes, maghanap syempre ng ng taxi, charot. Hindi. Maghanap ng CR, bes, charot. Maghanap na, hindi. Kasi hindi ako usually nag yeah, I think maganap ng kung saan yung way palabas.
Oh.
Yeah. Mm-mm. I think yun lang. Wala na naman, wala na naman kayo nakuha sa akin. Ano? I think
siguro nito na tawa.
Maganap na lang sasakyan palabas, bes. Ano bang gagawin? Alam nga naman tatambay ako sa airport, di ba? No. Airport, airport lang tayo. Airport to airport lang ang grabe.
Ano yung nagawa mo next?
Bes, kakain. Kakain talaga. Yeah. Kakain. Food.
Yeah, kasi hindi, the reason why I'm asking that is because hindi naman kasi lahat food yung ano yung pakaita. Although, I'm not sure. May iba kasi na more on ano lang talaga eh. Yung parang the
experience. Place.
Yung place lang talaga mismo.
Oo, true.
Diba, let's say, photos, taking photos. Ano, lahat naman tayo nagaganon. Pero there are people din kasi who takes most of the time just, let's say, capturing photos or alam mo yun, parang ganun. Wait lang. Sabi
yes,
best. Sabi ni Kuya Lito, oo, mahirap na, baka mawala ka sa place eh. Tapos, may pasanot pa siya. Ano pa ba? Nakakagutom kasi ang travel. Totoo naman, no? Gusto lang niya peace of mind. Ayan. Oh, kung may question ka, Kuya Lito. Kuya Lito, gusto mo ba mag-cameo appearance?
Ang taray talaga ng palive na to, no? Nakakatawa naman tong palive. Gagawin ko nga to. Halabanin ko nga tong season 2 episode 5 ni Bon.
Sige. Oh, ito na. Next question. Actually, this is, medyo pa approaching na tayo sa last part ng interview. Pero perhaps, ang next
question. Hey, Bon, para patapos na tayo. Nilaro-laro ko lang yun. Dapat ipopost mo ito sa Facebook mo, Bon? Totoo ba?
Sabi naman, may pa-appearance, di ako ready. Sabi, oy, Kuya Lito, nagmo-model ka kaya sa ngayon, nakita namin.
Oo, hindi na yan namamansin. Si Kuya Lito.
English
you're pa. You're not. Ito nga, Kuya Lito, din na ako nag-i-English eh. Naka-abstain ako sa English ngayon kasi week eh.
Ayun. Anyway, so, here's my next question. So kanina, di ba, you mentioned nga na parang there's this place that you really want. Kasi I ask you naman, where's this place that you really want to go with people or you mismo? So, pero meron ba na place sa mundo na ayaw mong puntahan? And why?
Ay, parang wala.
Oh.
Gusto ko talaga po, parang wala.
Mm-hmm.
Parang kasi I believe na parang sa lahat ng places na mapupuntahan mo, parang you have, kahit na sabihin ng iba na parang it's a worse place for them, parang you have something to learn from that country. Yeah, I think it's the experience. Yeah, kaya parang kasi diba parang it's, if it's worse for other people, it's technically it doesn't mean na parang worse na din yun for you unless you have been to that place. So I think gusto ko munang mapuntahan lahat ng mga places. Tapos from there siguro saka natin sabihin kung ano yung ayaw nating puntahan.
Yeah. Correct naman, no? So meaning to say, how do you consider other kasi gusto ko pala yung parang probing question. So how do you consider other people's opinion about a place even before you going there?
I don't consider other people's opinion. It's for my mental health. Gusto mo ba yun? I don't consider other people's opinion when I am traveling. Joke lang. Hindi, of course, you check parang nag-check ka rin ng reviews from reliable sources. Or from na nakapunta talaga sa place na yon, and para din matansya mo kung paano ka magbe-behave. Kasi di ba parang
yeah
like me, I'm a loud person. So baka naman mamaya, di ba, mag-WhatsApp bad lang people tayo sa ibang lugar tapos bawal pala yung parang very loud na person. So parang I think we need to make a little research from reliable sources. yeah, reliable sources, not sa fake news.
True.
Yeah, mag-stop tayo sa pag-spread ng fake news, guys. Okay? Sharp.
True. I agree. No? So, huwag tayo magaling kung hindi naman natin inaral ang isang bagay.
True. At saka pag hindi tayo graduate. Charot!
Tainis to.
Oo, ayun.
Wait lang. So,
charot lang.
Ito. Next question. So, when you go to a place, solo or not, are you comfortable meeting new people or do you just go there just for your own experience? And your friends' experiences?
I think, depende. Depende pa. It depends pa rin.
Hmm.
Kung, yeah, pero mostly, parang I just go there, yeah, for myself. Depende kasi hindi ako, kasi best, diba? Kasi, yeah, you need to speak English. And, you know, our capacity is just 2 hours a day. And
1 hour here.
And yeah, but instead of yeah using it to make friends, I'll just use it in asking like people like where to go, like things like that. Yeah, kasi parang pag especially now that it's COVID, so I think we should avoid. Yeah, not really avoid, but at least parang yung interaction na we do before, parang let's accept it na parang hindi na natin siya. We cannot do it anymore now. Kasi nga, COVID. Makapag-chikahan ka sa airport. Parang before I do that, like, even my seatmate in the airplane, I make chika-chika, like, where are you going? Like, I'm going to Nepal, like that. Oh, that's nice! Yeah. And then, end of conversation. That's nice, that's good! Yeah.
So more on personal benefit din talaga kasi inuuna natin no, kapag nagtatravel.
Oo, yeah.
So ayun. Kasi actually, so ito naman, next question. So was there a time in your travels wherein you got disappointed with how things went during your period of stay? And if so, how did you handle the situation?
Ano ba? Iisip ako, parang hindi ko sure kung meron. Wait. Iisip ko. Kung na-disappoint na ba ako na nag... Feeling ko wala akong naaalala na na-disappoint ako. Parang more on kasi ang na-ano sa akin, na-re-retain is parang yung happiness. Kasi nga, di ba, as what I said earlier, na I travel to free up my mind, tapos parang, yeah, for peace of mind rin, and para maging happy. So, I think yung mga yon parang yung mga disappointments or bad experiences na experience ko, parang nililive ko na din siya sa country na yun. Oo, kasi parang wala talaga akong maalala. Hindi ko din alam kung paano ko siya ginagawa, pero wala akong maalala.
Yeah.
Mga happy moments lang, mga ganyan. Mga kakain ng mga panis na hotdog, gano'n. Yun lang. Sharing.
Wait lang kasi, alam mo, saan ko
binibase yung... Tawa ka na naman, bro.
Wait lang, saan ko binibase yung questions ko? Doon sa travel natin sa Umalig. Kasi it's really very eventful that time. Naalala mo yung kinain natin sa mangka.
Yeah. Oh my God, pero
thankful naman na may...
It's a learning experience. Charot. It's a learning experience.
Ayun, anyway. Sige, so last few questions for you, Joe. So, perhaps, no, if you have a message to people who are actually, let's say, afraid to go on an adventure or let's say are very cautious, no, to go out of their comfort zones. So what can you say about to them?
Do not be afraid. Ano ba yun? Sinasabi ko. I mean, yeah, do not be afraid. Kasi there, though, parang, if you feel na parang hindi, parang medyo hindi safe dun sa pupuntahan mong place, parang there will always be good people who will... Yeah, help you find ways. Charot. BDO baka naman. No, yeah. On a serious note, yeah. Uh-huh. Even though parang based on like, because when you like research and then there are like things about that places, like there are a lot of like, for example, like pickpockets and all.
Uh-huh.
But yeah, when you just like jump into the right people na tama yung taong mapagtanungan mo, I think you'll be safe.
Mm. Yeah.
Kailangan mo lang ding maging ano, maging maingat, yeah. Maging maingat talaga and don't easily trust people. I think yung mapapayo ko lang, if pupunta sila sa mga places, is wag silang parang magtanong basta-basta sa strangers. I think it's safest to ask like yung mga security guards. Kasi yeah, parang security guards or yung mga police is everywhere naman if the place is quite not safe. So I think yeah, it's the best advice that I can give them. Like mag-ask sila sa mga guards or sa mga police, yeah.
Mm, yeah. So with that said, Joe, ano yung pinaka-adventurous activity that you've ever done in all your travels?
Best parang siguro yung ano, yung siguro sabihin ko, siguro parang wala naman kasi ako, hindi kasi ako adventurous type na person. I'm not that adventurous type na person. Like I don't go like mga bungee jumping and all. Kahit na may mga ganun, mga paragliding. Parang ayoko siyang gawin kasi ayoko mag-take ng risk. Yeah. Before, pero ngayon I think willing na ako kasi nga pandemic. So I think yung most is yun nga, yung pumunta tayo ng Humalik. Tapos yung alon is, yung alon dun sa Pacific Ocean is mas malalaki pa. Mas malaki pa kaysa sa bangka. Like, I literally prayed the Holy Rosary. I don't know. Hindi naman ako super religious na tao na araw-araw nagsisimba. Pero, yung time na yon, I literally prayed the Rosary and pray for my life. Kasi hindi alam ng parents ko na umalis ako ng ano. Na nandun na ako.
Nahila ka lang namin, di ba? Pumunta ka lang sa area. Joke talaga.
Oo. Tapos eh, pag ganun kasi ayoko na lang may mga nagjo-joke. Huwag na kayo mag-joke. Dasal nga tayo. Parang ganun, bigla ako nagiging ano, nagiging religyoso. But yeah.
Pero kasi nilala ko ngayon na nawawala-wala yung bangka na susundan natin.
Oo, nawawala. Oo, kasi at saka I don't know how to swim. So, kinuha ko talaga yung life jacket. Dadasal talaga ako for my life. For our lives, of course.
True. Kaya
magkakasama nun sa mga.
Correct. So, ayan. Actually, ano no, eto, this is my, ano, last question. Pero I don't know if the audience has, ano no, has something to ask you. Siguro, ano, if you would, describe your story, I mean, siguro not just today, no, or let's say, all the experiences that you had, in the past to now. So, how would you describe it in just one word? And why?
Bakit naman one word lang? Di ba pwedeng one sentence?
Oh, okay, one word, tapos i-explain mo.
One word? Totoo ba? Ano nga ulit yung tanong? One word to describe all my experiences?
Yeah. In traveling.
In traveling. I think, ano? Sige na nga, ano na lang? Freedom. I think freedom na lang.
Okay. Why?
Yeah. Kasi parang, I don't know. Kasi maybe because sa mga usual na mga pinupuntahan ko, parang medyo open country sila. So, parang nagiging, na-express ko yung self ko. So, yeah. I think that is what I meant by freedom. Na parang,
I can express
myself and parang yeah, freedom na parang malayo ka sa ano, sa lahat. Malayo ka sa emotional baggages, charot. And mga yeah, ayun.
Freedom. Nice. That's a nice word, ha. Actually, totoo naman 'yan. Kasi 'di ba sometimes kapag pumunta tayo sa mga place na ano, hindi usual sa atin, mas ano eh, mas na-express nga natin talaga no, kung how do we act, How do we express people and just live the experiences also. Ayun. So thank you for with the question. Hindi ko sure.
Guys, baka wala. Huwag na kayong magtanong, guys. Baka lalaroin nyo lang to eh.
Anyway, sige.
Next time na tayo, magpapalive selling ako. Abangan nyo live selling ko.
Anyway, wait lang.
Mag-live selling na lang ako, guys. Doon kayo mag-comment.
Ito, I'll share to you a quote from, taray, may pa-quote, from Mark Twain. No? So ito,
social law anong pa-quote?
Wait lang, basahin ko kasi hindi ko kabisado. Sabi ni Mark Twain, 20 years from now, you'll be more disappointed by the things you didn't do than the things you did do. So, sorry, hindi ko maalam. Throw off the bowlines, sail away from the safe harbor, catch the trade winds in your sails, explore, dream, and discover. And so, I hope for you, Bess, I hope that you continue to live your dreams. Go to places that you've never been to. Apply all the learnings in your life. No, and hopefully, you get to also inspire and uplift.
Very, very recollection naman to, Bes. Retreat ba to? Magtuuli ano ba tayo ng kandila, Bes?
Shabbat. Ito ay end the conversation.
Yeah, thank you.
Ayun, so.
Yeah, thank you for guesting.
Yes. Welcome. For now, just stay safe and healthy there, wherever you are. And I'm hoping that you can also go home in time to be with your family. And yeah, for now, looking forward lang for you, for your own well-being also. And thank you once again for taking the time tonight. Actually, lunchtime dyan, kaya nga tinanong kita if okay lang ba sa'yo na ma-esporbo ko yung...
Yeah, it's okay.
So, ayun. Thanks again, Best Joe. I really appreciate
it. Bye. You. Thanks, Boni.
Salamat. Press X lang. So that's it. I hope you enjoyed our discussion tonight with Joven, and I really enjoyed his thoughts on the topic. And hopefully, you'll continue to support What Is My Start Today in our future episodes. But for now, have a good night, everyone, and thank you once again. Good night.